Michael, can you name the 10 dirtiest players in the NHL right now, according to Ranker?
According to Ranker, 10 dirtiest players. Ooh. All right. I hate throwing him out at first as a guess, but Marchand?
Brad Marchand is number 2 on the list.
That's crazy to me. All right. All right. All right. See, this is such a tough question because you obviously can think of who the dirty guys are, but I don't know what Ranker's going to think.
Yeah, Ranker definitely is going to throw you some curveballs in this list.
Yeah, because I'm trying to think. You know, we always talk about the process. So I'm trying to think of guys that I think are dirty, but also maybe it's probably going to be guys who get in fights a lot against some scraps. I don't know. I also don't know how updated this could be. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, I'd say this is relative. Well, actually, all but one, I would say, are relatively updated. When you get to the one, I'll give you a couple hints.
All right. Well, I'm just going to start throwing some guests out there to kind of see where I can go. Tom Wilson.
Tom Wilson is the 101.
Yeah. Okay. I don't hate that.
That makes sense.
That makes sense. Just based off like suspensions and stuff.
Right.
I'm interested, like Ryan Reeves, would he be on here?
Ryan Reeves didn't make the cut.
Okay, I don't hate that. I don't think he's dirty. I just think he's,
Yeah, it seems like Ranker has differentiated fighting from dirty.
Yeah, no, totally.
I wouldn't call a lot of these guys like bruisers.
Yeah,
that's maybe one or two.
Yeah. All right, let's see. I'm going to keep going here. Kachuk, maybe?
Matthew Kachuk's number 4 on the list.
Okay, yeah, so I'm getting the right idea, I think.
You're in like that greasy, grimy area guys tend to be.
Yeah. I'm just trying to, you try to find all these guys in every team. So I'm trying to think of some more dirtiest players in the league. I mean, a name that's I want to get off my head is Arbor Jack Eye, Wi-Fi. I don't think he'd be on there.
He did not make the top 10.
That's kind of goes to the Reeves point with the fighters, but this honestly might stump me because there's probably a lot of players in the league that could be considered dirty that I'm not going to think of. I also don't know who's like still in the league, which sounds silly.
I think there's definitely 4 here that have probably been pinned with the dirty label pretty consistently throughout their career. 1 or 2 might be kind of iffy.
Yeah. What about Evander Kane?
Evander Kane is number 10. Yes.
Okay.
That's a good bet.
So closed out the list there. Corey Perry.
Corey Perry's number 8. There you go.
All right.
Now you're in the right neighborhood.
I hope so. Okay. Let's keep making my way kind of just around. If I just keep poking around on some teams, I might find some guys here. Maybe some defensemen. Who we got? Any greasy, dirty defensemen?
Not a bad way to go.
Yeah, no, I gotta start thinking of that because I got a lot of the forwards covered. There's plenty more of those where they came from, but
I give you a little help. You got 2 more forwards that were in that neighborhood with Perry. You were headed down the street.
Right? Yeah,
and honestly, Kachuk too. Like Kachuk lives in this general area.
Yeah, I know exactly what you're saying. I'm trying to think of guys. Some of these are going to bite, like they're going to bug me until I get them, which is natural. But let's see. Who do we got? This is tough. What about, I don't know if I love this answer, but maybe like Pat Maroon?
Pat Maroon isn't there, but I think that's another great guess.
Yeah. This is like harder than I thought it would be.
It's a hard list because it's an opinion.
Yeah, exactly.
You're not really looking for fact here.
Yeah. Trying to think of maybe some like guys who are meant to spend it. I just gotta think of those greasy grinders.
That's a good way to go about it.
Like suspensions and stuff?
At least for one of these guys, for sure.
Oh, that makes it even harder because now I really gotta get my brain going.
Actually, two technically.
What do you mean?
I don't know if I'm speaking misinformation here. One of these guys definitely suspensions.
Okay.
And play a good player. I would rope him in with Kachuk, a good player who puts up points, but he plays borderline and he's gotten himself in trouble with the Department of Player Safety before.
Okay. That is helpful. All right.
One that sticks out to me happened in the postseason.
Oh, God. Oh. Postseason. This past year. All right.
Not this past year.
Not this past year? Oh, no. Okay. All right.
I know the game and I know the year and I know the player he hit, but if you don't want it yet, I won't give it yet.
Well, I'll take a hint early. I don't hate that.
2019, he hits Jake DeBrusk and gets suspended for a couple games in the first round of the postseason.
Okay.
I believe it happened in game one of the Boston and team that this Boston team played against series.
Yeah. Oh, shit.
I also have like one more hint, like a for sure that I know, two more things that I know for sure about this player that would help if you need them.
Oh, before I take it, I'm just trying to make my way through the 2019. Bruce played the Leafs first round.
They did.
Okay. Dirty players on the Leafs. I think all of them, I fucking hate them all. It's crazy that I don't remember this hit. That's kind of where I'm bugging out.
This guy's definitely a little less relevant in today's NHL. I think he's mellowed out a little bit, but
I mean, I got a couple like.
He definitely got suspended in the first round.
Okay. I don't know if this is the right guy though. Where I'm going with that, because I'm thinking suspensions. I've been trying to think suspensions the whole time. Mm-hmm. And someone that rings a bell that's definitely mellowed out, and I think he has kind of bounced around a lot, is Gudas.
So Radko Gudas is on the list.
Yeah,
that's
I don't think that was
who I'm describing.
Yeah, I know.
Radko Gudas is number 7.
Okay. That's a good pull for me.
That also kind of that brings around a hint for another player, which I'm kind of now realizing there's a pattern. A lot of current and former Florida Panthers on this list.
Current and former. Oh, geez.
I guess the current you already got with Matt Kachuk.
Okay. Yeah.
Radko Gudas would be the former. There's one more. There's one more current.
Oh, one more current? I'm just going to go one for that then. Okay, so when you first said playoffs and conflict, I thought of Sam Bennett.
Sam Bennett's number 9.
Okay. All right. I'll have you. There we go.
So you're missing number 3, number 5, and number 6.
Interesting. All right. So this Leafs player, forward or defenseman?
Forward.
Dude, I'm going to fucking piss myself off until you get this. I don't know. This is Nazem Kadri, maybe?
Nazem Kadri. Yeah.
All right.
Good get. Yeah.
Yeah. All right. I'm very happy with that. All right.
My next hint was going to be he led his team in points last year and he won a Stanley Cup.
Yeah. Okay. Last year. Gotcha. But yeah. That once you said Leafs, then I was like, trying to timeline where the team was, but right then and there, it just hit me. Nazem Kadri. Okay. Yep. That's good. I'm glad.
So you're missing number 5 and number 3. Number 5, I will say, is on this list by technicality. He is technically active. He does not have a home.
Okay. All right.
I can throw you like a big hint, but I...
So you want to see if I get it first. Guys,
and then number 3, I don't know much about, but
all right, then I'm probably not going to get that one.
I can use the Google. I know one big thing about him that might help you, but it's not really about his style of play.
All right, with that number 5 guy, bruisers, not bruisers, but like tough guys who aren't technicality. That brings you to a couple guys. See, like, Jonathan Toews wasn't like that, but, like, I don't think he's technically retired.
Yeah, but it's not him. But same elk where he's not on a team, but he's not retired, so he's active.
All right. Technicality. Players who could be, but aren't. Couple names are coming up, but I'm trying to think if they're retired or not.
I think you know for a fact that this player is not retired.
Okay. Okay. Then that's giving me like two guys. Is it Lucic?
It's Milan Lucic. Yep.
Yeah. That's okay. When you said not rostered, but like could be technically. Okay. Yeah. That was a good pull. I don't think I'm getting number three. I can't think of another in the league.
Number three is the easiest hint I could give is that he and I share a first name.
All right. His name's Brendan.
I don't know much about this guy.
Yeah. I don't want to tap out because there's a lot of Brendans in the league, but I also might just fucking find a way to guess like six Brendans and get it right. Let's go. Brendan Gallagher.
No, but it should probably be him. I think he and Marshall are cut from the same cloth.
Yeah, I agree. Brendan Gallagher. That's Brandon, I think, but like, no, it's not Duhame.
No. Yeah, dude, I know nothing. I just Googled this guy and I didn't even know what team he was on.
Huh. See, I don't know if I'm going to pull this one out of my ass.
I believe his dad played in the NHL.
Huh.
Yes,
a lot of those guys.
His dad played for the Avs, the Devils, the Canadians, Coyotes.
Yeah, that's not helping. Which I appreciate it, but it's not the Brendan's with the same last name as their dad who played in the NHL. Fuck, I hate tapping out and I don't want to. But I'm really drawing blanks here.
9 out of 10 is not bad for that. Like, I would
not have gotten this player. But like that Lucic one I wouldn't have gotten without your hint. So I'm like happy I ended up leading that one. Yeah, I don't think I'm going to give a good Brendan yes. I also can't really think of any others that would be like dirty. I'll tap out at 9.
That's Brendan Lemieux.
Okay. I don't even know where he is right now either, honestly.
I think
I see that. L.A.? Okay, I do see
Carolina. That. Sorry, Carolina.
Three's, that's high. Did he get suspended?
That's very high for a player that I don't even know.
Yeah, that's kind of high.
I was shocked. Were you shocked that some people weren't on this list?
I mean, it's just like, what do you classify as dirty, though? Yeah, you know what I mean? So like, for me,
public perception... Jacob Trouba's very dirty.
Yeah, that's a good one.
I was kind of shocked that you had some guys on, like Corey Perry. I get that he's also perceived as dirty, but Jacob Trouba, with the way that he hits, I feel like everybody gives him shit for the way he plays.
I agree with that. He plays such a heavy game that it's like comes off like he doesn't regard for anyone.
Right.
Yeah, I don't know. I think for me, like I get confused with the difference between like the fighters and the guys that are, you know, just, you know, greasy, dirty guys. So, but I'll take that. I got some good pulls there. Some of them I definitely knew, but I appreciate your help. That was good. That was a good list.